Dear brothers and sisters, since the beginning of Lent until now, we have prepared our hearts by penance and charitable works. Today we gather together to herald with the whole church the beginning of the celebration of our Lord's Paschal Mystery, that is to say, of his passion and resurrection. For it was to accomplish this mystery that he entered his own city of Jerusalem. Therefore, with all faith and devotion, let us commemorate the Lord's entry into the city for our salvation, following his footsteps, so that being made by his grace partakers of the cross, we may have a share also in his resurrection and in his life. Almighty ever-living God, sanctify these branches with your blessing, that we who follow Christ the King in exaltation may reach the eternal Jerusalem through him who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, Lord.
When Jesus and his disciples drew near to Jerusalem, to Bethany and Bethany at the Mount of Olives, he sent two of his disciples and said to them, "Go into the village opposite you, and immediately on entering it, you will find a colt tethered on which no one has ever sat. Untie it and bring it here. If anyone should say to you, 'Why are you doing this?' reply, 'The master has need of it,' and will send it back here at once." So they went off and found a colt tethered to a gate outside on the street, and they untied it. Some of the bystanders said to them, "What are you doing untying the colt?" They answered them, "Just as Jesus had told them to," and they permitted them to do it. So they brought the colt to Jesus and put their cloaks over it, and he sat on it. Many people spread their cloaks on the road, and others spread leafy branches that they had cut from the fields. Those preceding him, as well as those following, kept crying out, "Hosanna! Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Blessed is the kingdom of our father David that has come. Hosanna in the highest." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Dear brothers and sisters, like the crowd who acclaimed Jesus in Jerusalem, let us go forth in peace. Let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, who, as an example of humility for the human race to follow, caused our Savior to take flesh and submit to the cross, graciously grant that we may heed his lesson of patient suffering and so merit to share in his resurrection, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. The Lord has given me a well-trained tongue, that I might know how to speak to the weary, a word that will rouse them. Morning after morning, he opens my ear that I may hear, and I have not rebelled, have not turned back. I gave my back to those who beat me, my cheeks to those who plucked my beard, my face I did not shield from buffets and spitting. The Lord God is my help, therefore I am not disgraced. I have set my face like flint, knowing that I shall not be put to shame. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
my God, why have you abandoned me?
My God, why have you abandoned me?
All who seek me scoff at me. They mock me with parted lips. They wag their heads. He relied on the Lord. Let him deliver him. Let him rescue him if he loves him.
My God, why have you abandoned me?
Indeed, many dogs surround me. A pack of evildoers closes in upon me. They have pierced my hands and my feet. I can count all my bones.
My God, why have you abandoned me?
They divide my garments among them, and from my vesture they cast lots. But you, O Lord, be not far from me. O my help, hasten to aid me.
My God, why have you abandoned me?
I will proclaim your name to my brethren. In the midst of the assembly, I will praise you. You who fear the Lord, praise him. All you descendants of Jacob, give glory to him. Revere him, all you descendants of Israel.
My God.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Philippians. Christ Jesus, though he was in the form of God, did not regard equality with God something to be grasped. Rather, he emptied himself, taking the form of a slave, coming in human likeness and found human in appearance. He humbled himself, becoming obedient to the point of death, even death on a cross. Because of this, God greatly exalted him and bestowed on him the name which is above every name, that at the name of Jesus, every knee should bend, of those in heaven and on earth and under the earth, and every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
As soon as morning came, the chief priests with the elders and the scribes, that is, the whole Sanhedrin, held a council. They bound Jesus, led him away, and handed him over to Pilate. Pilate questioned him.
Are you the king of the Jews?
He said to him in reply,
You say so.
The chief priests accused him of many things. Again, Pilate questioned him.
Have you no answer? See how many things they accuse you of?
Jesus gave him no further answer, so that Pilate was amazed. Now on the occasion of the feast, he used to release to them one prisoner whom they requested. A man called Barabbas was then in prison along with the rebels who had committed murder in a rebellion. The crowd came forward and began to ask him to do for them as he was accustomed. Pilate answered,
Do you want me to release to you the king of the Jews?
For he knew that it was out of envy that the chief priests had handed him over. But the chief priests stirred up the crowd to have him release Barabbas for them instead. Pilate again said to them in reply,
Then what do you want me to do with the man you call the king of the Jews?
They shouted again,
Crucify him.
Pilate said to them,
Why? What evil has he done?
They only shouted the louder,
"Crucify him."
So Pilate, wishing to satisfy the crowd, released Barabbas to them, and after he had had Jesus scourged, handed him over to be crucified. The soldiers led him away inside the palace, that is, the praetorium, and assembled the whole cohort. They clothed him in purple, and weaving a crown of thorns, placed it on him. They began to salute him with,
"Hail, King of the Jews,"
and kept striking his head with a reed and spitting upon him. They knelt before him in homage, and then when they had mocked him, they stripped him of the purple cloak, dressed him in his own clothes, and led him out to crucify him. They pressed into service a passerby, Simon of Cyrene, who was coming from the country, the father of Alexander and Rufus, to carry his cross. They brought him to the place of Golgotha, which is translated place of the skull. They gave him wine drugged with myrrh, but he did not take it. Then they crucified him and divided his garments by casting lots for them to see what each should take. It was 9 o'clock in the morning when they crucified him. The inscription of the charge against him read, "The King of the Jews." With him, they crucified 2 revolutionaries, one on his right and one on his left. Those passing by reviled him, shaking their heads and saying,
"Aha! You who destroyed the temple in 3 days, save yourself and come down from the cross."
Likewise, the chief priests with the scribes mocked him among themselves and said,
"He saved others, cannot I save himself? Let the Christ, King of Israel, come down from the cross, that we may see him and believe."
Those who were crucified with him also kept abusing him. At noon, darkness came upon the whole land until 3 in the afternoon. And at 3 o'clock, Jesus cried out in a loud voice,
"Eloi, Eloi, lama sabachthani,"
which is translated,
my God, why have you forsaken me?"
Some of the bystanders who heard it said,
"Look, he's calling Elijah."
One of them ran, soaked a sponge with wine, put it on a reed, and gave it to him to drink, saying,
"Wait, let us see if Elijah comes to take him down."
Jesus gave a loud cry and breathed his last. Top to bottom. When the centurion who stood facing him saw how he breathed his last, he said,
"Surely this was the Son of God."
The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Good morning.
Oh my God.
The Roman Missal, which is the book that sits upon our altar, the book that the priest uses as his guide to pray the divine liturgy, the Mass, has a line written whenever the Passion is read. And that line states that a brief homily could be given if appropriate, if not a period of silence. So I hope you understand why I will choose to be brief this morning. As Mass began, we listened again to the story of Palm Sunday. How Jesus makes his entrance into Jerusalem riding a donkey. The donkey, it's a noble steed in the Bible. We find the donkey stories through the Old Testament and the New Testament. It's a major figure. The donkey is very important as a beast of burden. But we can learn a lot from the donkey at this moment. For as the people rejoiced, as they threw their cloaks down on the way, as they sang Hosanna, as they held up their palm branches, it was all directed to Jesus. None of that was directed to the donkey. That moment in history was not about the donkey. It was about Jesus. That's important to remember. Because we can take that and apply it into our spiritual life. It's never about us. It's always about Jesus. You and I are called to imitate the donkey and bring Jesus to others. Not for any praise of our own, not for any earthly reward, because it's about Jesus and not about us. That individual we bring Jesus to, they need Jesus. They don't need us. Because He is the divine healer. He is the divine counselor. He is the one who can help them. Our role is to bring Jesus to others. This may strike some differently. Now it seems churches have moved into a moment where we focus on bigger, grandiose celebrations. We have to have mega churches. We have to have the big screens. We have to have the auditorium, amphitheater style seating. We have to have the worship music done with full bands wearing skinny jeans. We have to have clean shaven ministers. We have to have the coffee shop in the back. We have to have the stuff, the free stuff we pawn out on you. Bumper stickers, t-shirts, hats. Those pins that can write upside down and in water. That's not what it's about. If that's what it takes to get someone to come to Jesus, great. But it's not about that. It's about Jesus. It's not about us. Whether the minister is the best homilist or the worst homilist, where he's clean shaven or bearded, whether he's tall and short, slim or not slim, whether the music is elegant or there's no music at all, whether the mass leaves you wanting to run around, say amen, jump and dance and sing, or you just leave quietly, it's always about Jesus. It's never about us. May we imitate the donkey. And as a motto, Saint Ignatius of Loyola, Ad majorem gloriam Dei, all for the glory of God, not us. May Almighty God be with you, may He bless you, the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Let us stand for our profession of faith, our creed.
I believe in one God, Father.
together as one family of faith, let us offer to God our prayers and our needs.
On the cross, Jesus knew that he could call out to his Father, and he would be heard. As children of God, we now bring our prayers before God, confident that we too will be heard. Let's pray to the Lord. For all of God's holy church, that we may be a visible sign to the others as we follow the way of the cross in the world today, let us pray to the Lord. For peace in areas of the world beset by war, hostility, and conflict, especially in the lands where Jesus walked, let us pray to the Lord. For those who are in prison, that they may find comfort in the Lord and not lose hope, let us pray to the Lord. That Jesus' reliance on God through his passion and death may be a model for us in our trials and suffering, let us pray to the Lord. For those who feel abandoned, who feel they have no one to turn to, that they may realize that they can always turn to God and that God will never abandon them, let us pray to the Lord. For all the prayers that we hold in the silence of our hearts, for all our intentions, spoken and unspoken, let us pray to the Lord.
And lastly, let us pray this Mass for you, the parish families of St. Bridget and St. Thomas the Apostle, and for the parish family of those who will watch this Mass on video. This Mass is offered for all of you in your needs. We pray to the Lord. Offering all our prayers to the Father, let us conclude with a prayer in honor of the Blessed Trinity.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
Through your goodness, we have received the bread we offer you, Fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation. Through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. Together with Francis, our Pope, and Thomas, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him.
Thank you. mercy of Christ.
Let us pray. Nourished with these sacred gifts, we humbly beseech you, O Lord, that just as through the death of your Son, you have brought us to hope for what we believe, so by his resurrection, you may lead us to where you call. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth, the Mass is ended.
Thanks be to God.
But before you go forth, remember, please take a bulletin home. It has the Holy Week schedule in it, because next Sunday Mass will not be at 9, it'll be at 8. So please be aware of that, okay? And for anyone having young children, they're having an Easter egg hunt at St. Thomas after the 11th. Am I correct?
Yes.
So you're more than invited to go to that. Thank y'all. Y'all have a good day. Oh, thank you. Prayer to St. Michael for the protection of our parishes and our families.
Holy Michael, the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our protection against the enemy's snares and the devil. May God
divine graces for protection against storms, hurricanes, and other disasters.
Blessed be God. Blessed be his holy name. Blessed be Jesus Christ, the God of your name. Blessed be the name of Jesus. Blessed be his most sacred heart. Blessed be his most precious blood. Blessed be Jesus, the most holy sacrament on the altar. Blessed be the Holy Spirit, the Consoler. Blessed be the great Mother.
Let us see her glorious sunshine. Let us see the name of Mary, Virgin Mother. Let us see the name.